I will be extremely brief, and unfortunately we will not be able to take any questions, but we will be giving a state of homeland security address in the next fortnight. That should give you an opportunity at that time to ask some of the questions related to our national security that could be pertinent at that time. So you'll bear with us for today. We want to restrict ourselves to the topic of the day. The government of Kenya undertakes to all persons within the borders of our country that it will respect, uphold, promote, and fulfill the inalienable constitutional right of every person peaceably and unarmed to assemble, to demonstrate, to picket, and to present petitions to authorities. According to Article 24, 1D of the Constitution, this right, as all other rights, is limited by, among other things, the need to ensure that the enjoyment of this right does not prejudice the rights and freedoms of others. It follows, therefore, that those exercising the Article 37 rights to assemble, to demonstrate, to picket, and to present petitions to public authorities peaceably and unarmed must do so under the following constitutional and legal parameters. One, they must remain peaceful and unarmed throughout the assembly, the demonstration, the picketing, and the presentation of any petitions to authorities. Two, they must engage in a manner that does not promote violence or riots, because the right in Article 37 is the right to demonstrate. It is not the right to riot. Number three, they must not breach public order. Number four, they must not intimidate, harass, or otherwise inconvenience members of the public who are not protesting. Number four, they must inform the police of their intentions to exercise this right. They must also inform the police of the routes they will take for purposes of providing escorts and ensuring that there is law and order during this constitutional expression. They must also notify the police the timings of their activities. They must stop their activities at sunset or at 6:30 p.m., whichever is earlier, in accordance with the Public Order Act, Cap 57 of the Laws of Kenya. They must not provoke, attack, injure, or obstruct law enforcement officers or even members of the public. They must also follow the escorts and other guidelines of law enforcement officers to ensure they are protected from non-protesters, they are protected from infiltrators, and they are orderly as they exercise this very fundamental right provided for under the Constitution for every person. They must not obstruct traffic of any kind. Motor vehicle traffic, bicycle traffic, border traffic, etc., etc. They must not obstruct, block, vandalize, or otherwise destroy any private or public property. They must adhere to the laws of Kenya, including the Protected Areas Act that limits access to certain critical infrastructure for national security reasons. And the police will guide them in which areas they cannot access by operation of the law on the protection of critical infrastructure. They must not access critical assets for the supply of power, water, or other social amenities in a manner that is likely to interfere with the enjoyment of these amenities by members of the public. They must not interfere with any private activity by non-protesters, and they must not interfere with road, rail, sea, or air transport in any manner whatsoever. Whatever the issues, whatever the grievances, whatever the matter, the rule of law and public order must be maintained by all persons. For the avoidance of doubt, non-protesters and other members of the public who hold a contrary view to that of protesters are bound by the same limitations, and they must exercise their right to disagree, if at all, in the same manner, in the same circumstances. The national security organs of our country shall remain neutral, apolitical, but firm in enforcing the law of our country, and no form of lawlessness is going to be entertained whatsoever. Ladies and gentlemen, those who wish to exercise their constitutional right can do so today, tomorrow, every day, because it is their right to do so. But they must also adhere to the rule of law, and they need to make sure that other members of the public who either are not interested in what they are doing or they hold a public, a contrary view, are also not inconvenienced or harassed in any manner, including the transportation of the people. In the past, we have seen grave breaches to peace. We have seen people pretending to be protesters damaging road infrastructure and other amenities built by the taxes and the sweat of the people of Kenya. I dare you to try that. We cannot be a country that condones violence in the name of exercising human rights. Your right and my right and where the right of the next person starts. I repeat, your right and my right and at the point where the right of the next person starts. Nataka niseme ya kwamba Katiba ya Kenya inakubalia mtu yoyote kufanya maandamano ya amani bila kujihami. Lakini katiba hiyo hiyo imesema kwamba wakati mtu yoyote anafurahia haki hii ya kibinadamu ambayo iko katika katiba, ni lazima aheshimu haki za wale watu wengine ambao labda hawahusiki na mambo ambayo anafanya. Kwa hivyo, katika wakati huu, tumepata habari ya kwamba kuna wananchi ambao wangetaka kujieleza na kuandamana kwa sababu wanatofautiana na maamuzi fulani ambao yamefanywa yakiwa maamuzi ya umma. Uhuru wao wa kujieleza uko katika katiba. Vyombo vya usalama vya taifa la Kenya vitawalinda ili wajieleze, waandamane na vile vile wafanye chochote ambacho wanaweza kufanya, ikiwemo kupeleka matakwa yao katika ofisi ama mahali ambazo wangetaka kusikizwa. Lakini wanapofanya hivyo lazima wazingatie katiba na sheria ya nchi ya Kenya. Wasidhulumu wananchi, wasidhulumu ama kuingilia kazi ya walinda usalama. Vile vile wasiumize miundo misingi ya taifa la Kenya. Na vile vile kuna sheria ambazo zinatumiwa katika sehemu maalum ambazo zimelindwa kisheria kwa sababu ya usalama wa taifa, na maafisa wetu wa polisi watawaelekeza ni wapi na wapi hawawezi kufikia, na ni lazima watii amri ambao watapewa na wale ambao ni walinda usalama watakaoelekeza. Wakifuata hiyo sheria wako na uhuru wa kufanya shughuli yao, lakini lazima wakome hiyo shughuli ifikapo saa 12:30 jioni ama jua linapotua, kwa sababu kazi hiyo haiwezi kuendelea kwa giza, kwa sababu polisi wetu na vyombo vya usalama havina uhakika ya kwamba vitalinda wewe kama wewe unaandamana wakati wa giza, kwa sababu ya hali vile itakuwa. Kwa hivyo mimi nataka niwahakikishie kwamba vyombo vya usalama wa taifa vitabaki bila kuwa na misimamo ya kisiasa. Kazi yetu ni kulinda usalama wa taifa letu na kuhakikisha wahalifu na wakora hawatumii sababu zozote kuumiza usalama wetu na kuhujumu amani ya nchi. Kwa hivyo vile vile, kama kuna wananchi wako na maoni tofauti na wale wataandamana, hayo maoni vile vile kama wanataka kutoa wanaweza kuyatoa, lakini lazima wafuate sheria hizo hizo. Wasiwe na silaha, wasivuruge amani, wasihujumu kasi ya walinda usalama, na wasiingie katika sehemu ambazo asiruhusiwi kwa sababu ya kiusalama. Tumeona hapo awali miundo misingi na vifaa ambavyo vimeundwa na jasho na kodi ya wananchi vikiharibiwa ikiwemo barabara, na hiyo haitaruhusiwa kamwe. Na wale wanafikiri hii ni taarifa tu tunatoa, wajaribu hivyo leo, kesho ama kesho kutwa. We will be extremely firm, fellow Kenyans. It doesn't matter whether you're supporting the demonstrators or you're against the demonstrators, we will treat you as a criminal. And we are going to be very firm and very unapologetic, because we do not want to interfere with our democracy. But at the same time, this country is the only country we have. And the rule of law is the only one, is the only thing that puts us together and makes us equal and ensures that the weak and the mighty, the big and the small, the powerful and the weak can exercise their freedoms and feel protected under the law. I wish you all the best. Have a good evening. In about a fortnight or so, we will be addressing the nation on the state of our homeland security, on all the issues from A to Z. As I promised last year, we will be holding regular public accountability forums to tell the people of Kenya where we are, the challenges we are facing, the achievements we have made, and where we think we need to improve, as a way of opening up security as a public good to scrutiny, accountability, and public oversight. Thank you very much. Have a good evening.